Welcome to the next session on commodity derivatives and risk management. And if you recall, we discussed that in the last session, we discussed that we will be starting the crude oil derivatives details in this session. So all of us, we understand the importance of petrol, diesel in our life. And this is something, you know, we cannot do away without. So the importance of crude oil and the refined product in our life has been succinctly given by this particular quote. So let me start this. So a century ago, petroleum, what we call oil, was just an obscure commodity. Today it is almost as vital to human existence as water. So James Buchan has mentioned this. So from this statement and from our you know, daily life, we understand how important is crude oil. Now all of us also, you know, as an Indian citizen or people who are keeping track of what is happening in Indian economy, we know that whenever crude oil prices goes up, it has a significant impact on the current account deficit and you know, other macroeconomic measures. So let's before we start today's discussion on how crude oil price risk can be mitigated, it is very important to understand different aspects of crude oil. And in the last couple of session, if you recall, I brought some beans to tell you which one is a soybean. And of course, the same thing, I cannot do it today, that I cannot bring you a liter or a, you know, some amount of crude oil to show you exactly what is crude oil. Okay, nevertheless, let's start our understanding on what is exactly, what do we mean by crude oil, what do we mean by crude oil price when we say that prices is increasing. So which price? So every country produces crude oil. In fact, there are some you know, upstream companies in India like ONGC, Reliance and Cairn India, who are into crude oil exploration and mining. Which crude oil is represents the global market? And so this different aspect, let's first understand, and then we will be proceeding to understand more about how derivative contracts are used by consumers of refined products, crude oil refined products, and as well as producers of crude oil, and how price volatility affects their profitability. Now, crude oil means rock oil, and it's a complex mixture of hydrocarbons of various molecular composition, plus other organic compounds and trace metals like nitrogen, oxygen, and sulfur. So, crude oil is what gets extracted from the underground mines. So, you have and one crude oil normally measured in terms of barrel, and one barrel is equivalent to 42 gallons, and 1 gallon is equivalent to 3.785 liter. And as all of you must be knowing, that crude oil cannot be used as it is. Crude oil needs to be refined to generate refined products which we use. So one barrel of crude oil, which is equivalent to 42 gallons of crude oil, can be processed to generate 2 gallons of liquid petroleum gas, 19 gallons of petrol, and 10 gallons of diesel, and 4 gallons of kerosene or jet fuel. And all of you, I mean, I don't know whether you were aware of it, the kerosene, which you know, we have seen being sold in public distribution system all over India. That kerosene is the same kerosene is used as aviation turbine fuel, that ATF. And of course not the same quality, more finer and more superior quality of kerosene is used by airlines company as ATF. So kerosene or jet fuel is generated is 4 gallons. Fuel oil is 2 gallons. Heating oil is 1 gallon, and finally other residue like paraffin wax etc. It is 7 gallons. So if you see, if you add up all these outputs, it comes out to almost 45 gallons. And where does the extra 3 gallon come from? So this is known as the processing gain of 3 gallons. So if a company is producing or extracting 1 barrel of crude oil, which is equivalent to 42 gallons of crude oil, that company will be able to produce 45 gallons of this combination of outputs. So this particular picture I have taken, this image I have taken from the website which is mentioned here. So there are many images available in the Google in terms of explaining the process of refining, but this particular picture I personally like. If you can see, this crude oil goes into the boiler. Depending on the temperature, you have LPG, you have different petrochemical products, you have gasoline, that is your petrol, and you have jet fuel, kerosene for lighting and heating, and you have a diesel fuel, you have different kinds of lubricants and waxes and polishes, and you have a bunker fuel. And bunker fuel is the fuel which is used by big ships for carrying different goods from one country to another country. So you have bunker fuel, and for running boilers etc. And you have also finally paraffin wax for road and roofing. So the black tar which we see on our roads also comes from the process of crude oil refining process. Of course, if you are more interested in understanding how exactly this happens, you can visit websites, different websites, and you will be able to find out more information pertaining to the crude oil refining process. And if you recall, we also discussed in the last class, if you are going to be a trader, or if you are interested in trading commodity derivative, the first and foremost thing to start is to understand what is the underlying commodity you are going to deal with. So this starts with understanding all aspects of the commodity. So in today's session, we are going to spend couple of minutes in understanding different aspect of the crude oil. Here, in the refining process, one interesting concept I thought of sharing, that is called your Nelson complexity index. So this complexity index, or this index, measures the capability of a refiner, measures the capability of a refinery to alter the product mix in response to market demand, as well as change in the type and quality of crude oil input. So as we go along, we will be discussing different types of crude oil which is produced all over the world. So this crude oil can be categorized as heavy or light, can be categorized as sour or sweet crude. So depending upon the advanced refining process a refiner has, which is measured by the Nelson complexity index. So higher the index, better the capability of a refiner to take in all kinds of crude oil as input, and also change the product mix depending upon the market demand. Let's say all of a sudden, if a company decides that aviation turbine fuel is in greater demand, then it may reduce the amount of petrol or diesel it is producing. It may focus more on producing ETFs. So depending upon the Nelson Complexity Index, a refiner has the flexibility to change the input, kind of input it is taking in, as well as the product mix, the output product mix also can be changed. Now, who is the, who in Indian context, who is the best refinery as of today? So the index for Indian refinery during 2015 is that the IOC, Indian Oil Corporation's Paradip refinery stands at 12.2, SR Oil's Bhadinar refinery is 11.8, Reliance Jamnagar refining complex has 11.3, and BPCL's Bina refinery is 9.1. So each and every refinery complex in the world as well as India can be, the efficiency of these refinery units can be measured using the Nelson Complexity Index. Now, why are we discussing this? So, this gives us an indication on how flexible a refiner is. It will be able to undertake its physical process such that it will be able to get benefit from the prevailing market situation. So, if a commodity is lower, is ruling at a low price, if a refiner product is ruling at a lower price, that refiner may reduce production of that product and also increase the other product in which it has got the possibility of getting a better return. Now, let's discuss little more on crude oil types. In the world, as per the International Crude Oil Market Handbook 2010, which is produced by United States Energy Intelligence Group, there are 160-odd variety of crude oil in terms of their origin of production and quality grade. So, all over the world, there are different companies at different geographical locations produce crude oil, which can be which categories can be as diverse as 160 varieties. We talk about only 3 to 4 varieties, and these are known as your oil markers or marker crudes. So many times you may have heard that Brent is quoting at this much, WTI is quoting at this much. So globally, predominantly, when people talk about crude oil price, they mention the price of one of these marker crudes. So out of 160 varieties, 4 of these varieties are popularly quoted. So, which are these 4? You have North America's West Texas Intermediate, or popularly known as WTI crude. You have North Sea Brent crude. You have OPEC reference basket, and you have UAE Dubai crude. And how these 160 varieties can be segregated from one over the other? So, this is based on 2 parameters. One is your API gravity measure, and other one is the amount of sulfur the crude contains. So, what API stands for? API stands for American Petroleum Institute gravity. So, this particular API gravity measures the relative density of crude oil against water. So, if a particular variety of crude oil is lighter, it will have a higher API index. So, higher the API index, better the quality of crude oil. So, it is it's thinner and it is lighter, so it floats against when it's mixed with the water, it floats above the water. So, that is one measure of knowing which is the better quality of crude oil. So, this particular slide shows crude oil variance based on the API. When we talk about a crude oil as a light crude oil, this particular crude oil variety should have a API measure greater than 31.1 degree. Similarly, medium crude oil will be 22.3 degree to 31.1 degree, and heavy crude oil is less than 22.3 degree. Similarly, the second major of knowing the quality of the crude oil is measured through the sulfur content. So if a particular crude oil variety has higher sulfur component, then it is known as a sour crude oil, and if it is it has got lesser sulfur component, it is known as a sweet crude oil. There is slight mistake in this particular slide, so please ignore this one. The sweet will be less than 0.05 and sour will be greater than 0.05%. So please make note of it when we are talking about a crude oil variety which is called a sour crude oil. That means it has got a higher sulfur percentage. So the light sweet crude oil is the best type of crude oil. And why are we saying it's the best type of crude oil? It requires the least amount of refining cost, and it also commands a price premium, because all over the world crude oil is used as a input to the refiner, and the refiners use this crude oil to generate refined products which are used by the consumers. So light sweet crude oil requires the least amount of refining cost. And let's go to the this two components with respect to the four marker crudes I mentioned. So WTI crude has a API gravity of 39.6 degree and sulfur percentage of 0.24%. So WTI crude is known as a light sweet crude oil. Similarly, you have a Brent crude is 38.3 degree centigrade, API 38.3 degree, API gravity starts at 38.3 degree, and it has got a sulfur percentage of 0.37%. And if you see for the other two, the API gravity is reducing and the sulfur percentage is increasing. Now how these out of this 160 crude oil varieties, how these four have been identified as marker crudes? So what are the criteria for a particular crude variety to be called as a marker crude? So the main criteria for a marker crude is to be sold in sufficient volume to provide liquidity in the physical market. So if many people are buying and selling, and the volume volume traded for that particular variety of crude oil is higher, then many people would like to know what is the price prevailing for these crudes, and globally many organizations report the price of these four variety of crudes, and slowly over the period of time these crudes come to be known as marker crudes. And other crude oil is priced at a premium or discount to these markers. So if a company is producing a crude which has got let's say better API gravity and lesser sulfur percentage, it will be trading at a, or this particular company when it is selling the crude oil to a refiner, it will be selling at a premium to the WTI crude. So the importance of this crude oil markers could be understood from the fact that these are highly reported, widely reported crude oil prices, and these four crude oil is consumed by many are traded by many buyers and sellers. Let's talk about crude spot price. So when we talk about WTI spot price or Brent crude spot price, what is that? I mean, how do we know which price? Because you know, crude oil could be crude oil could be mined by many companies at a given point of time by in a country. So when we talk about WTI spot price or West Texas Intermediate spot price, what do we mean by that? So this WTI spot price indicates the price of barrel of crude oil for delivery at Cushing, Oklahoma, USA. So whenever the price prevailing at spot delivery at Cushing, Oklahoma, USA is known as the spot price, WTI spot price. And importance of this particular location Cushing at USA can be understood from this particular video. I'm going to show you this video for a couple of minutes, so please bear with me for some time.
Is your business
strategy? This is a small advertisement, so please ignore that.
Better the question, better the answer, better the world works.
EY, exclusive sponsor of the CNBC Global CFO Council.
Welcome to Cushing, Oklahoma, 70 miles northeast of Oklahoma City. This is a tiny town, population just under 8,000, but while it may be small, it plays a big role in the oil business. Just how big? Well, there's nearly 50 million barrels of oil in these tank farms. Barrel of oil breaks down to 42 gallons. That means there's more than 2 billion gallons of crude oil surrounding this small Oklahoma town. This place is nicknamed the Pipeline Crossroads of the World because, well, there are dozens of pipelines bringing crude in and out of Cushing. But with U.S. oil priced below 50 bucks a barrel, there's currently more crude oil coming into Cushing than going out. That's because traders can make a bigger profit storing their supply and selling at a later date for a higher price. So it may not look like much, but the residents of this sleepy town have some $2.5 billion worth of black gold in their backyards.
So I hope you got to see these or understand the importance of Cushing, Oklahoma, USA with respect to the WTI spot price. So the price prevailing for crude oil delivery at this pipeline center and storage location at Cushing is the spot price of WTI. Similarly, what is a Brent crude? And in the couple of slides before, I mentioned the word North Sea Brent. So Brent crude spot price indicates it is a blend of crude oil from 15 different oil fields located near the North Sea, and the spot price for Brent crude is the price for delivery at Sullomvoy oil terminal near Scotland. So the price prevailing for oil buying and selling at Sullomvoy oil terminal near Scotland is the spot price prevailing for the North Sea Brent. And in the slide, you can see it, one black and white picture and one color picture, and both these pictures say shows the same same location. So you can see some oil storage locations as well as pipelines, and these pipelines are projecting to the North Sea. Specifically, if you can see, these pipelines have has come into the North Sea, and you have ships coming, and the ships or tankers, crude oil tankers come to this North Sea and get filled in. So buyers and sellers, whoever is interested to buy or sell crude oil at this North Sea Brent crude oil at this location, the price what they pay is the spot price prevailing for the North Sea Brent crude. The third marker crude is your OPEC reference basket, and I'm sure all of you must have heard an organization called Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. So this OPEC reference basket is the average of spot prices of crude oil produced by OPEC member countries. So this OPEC reference basket is the average of the spot price of the crude oil which is produced by these OPEC nation, OPEC members. And at this point of time, I would like to just briefly discuss a little bit on about OPEC and the link of this organization of petroleum exporting countries. OPEC link will, if you, you know, the link will be available. You spend some time understanding the history of OPEC, when it was formulated, what was the mandate, how OPEC has been instrumental in controlling the production as well as the supply of crude oil all over the world. So different aspect pertaining to the crude oil prices is very, very clearly given. So just to briefly discuss, OPEC reported the price for this reference basket for the first time in 1st January 1987. So OPEC was created, if I am not mistaken, OPEC was created for the first time in 1966, and but it reported the price of this reference basket for the first time in 1st January 1987. And till 15 June 2005, OPEC reference basket had arithmetic average of prices of crude oil produced at seven different countries. So seven different OPEC members, they were producing different varieties of crude oil, and the spot prices were different depending upon the different variety. And OPEC reference basket was the arithmetic average of the price of crude oil produced at the seven different countries. And which were the seven different countries? So you have Algeria's Saharan belt, you have MENA's from Indonesia, you have Nigeria, you have Arab Light, you have Fateh Dubai, you have Tijuana Light Venezuela, and Isthmus Mexico. And from so these seven different varieties of crude oil price was the arithmetic average was calculated and reported as the spot price of OPEC reference basket. However, with other members joining OPEC from 16 June 2005 onwards, this list was expanded to 11 different types of crude oil. And from our simple arithmetic average, it became OPEC started using the weighted average crude oil price for these 11 different crude varieties to arrive at the spot price. And the weights were based on the production and export volume. So if a country is producing more and exporting more, then that country will have a higher weightage in the calculation of OPEC reference basket. Okay, the fourth crude marker is the Dubai crude light. So Dubai crude light is a, if you see, it is a light sour crude extracted from the Dubai region. And this particular crude oil price is used as a benchmark for crude oil produced from the Persian Gulf region. And this is one of the most popular oil price benchmark in Asia. So most of the buyers and sellers from the Asia price their crude output, most of the sellers from Asia price their crude output with respect to the Dubai crude light. Besides those four oil markers, there are other couple of other benchmarks which are also reported on regular basis. One is your Argus sour crude index. If you recall, this four crude markers were light sweet. First three crude markers were light sweet, and the last one was light sour. But this Argus sour crude index is a volume weighted average price index of medium sour crude. Let me highlight, it is a medium sour crude, it is not a light sour crude. So it's a volume weighted average price index of medium sour crude oil trading at US Gulf of Mexico, and many companies use this one as a benchmark price for pricing their crude oil. For example, Saudi Arab's national oil company Saudi Aramco started using this particular benchmark, this particular index, to price all its crude oil exports to USA from July 2010 onwards. Prior to this date, Saudi Aramco was using WTI crude oil price as the reference price. Similarly, you have another index called Japan Crude Cocktail Index. So Petroleum Association of Japan calculates this Japan crude cocktail index. It is the monthly average import price of customs cleared crude oil imported to Japan. So this index is again used by many crude producers from the ASEAN region. Finally, with respect to India, you have international crude oil price for Indian basket. And this is prepared by Ministry of, this index is reported by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas of India, and it has a sale called Petroleum Planning and Analysis Sale. This sale, on a daily basis, it reports the price of this basket, and it considers the UAE Dubai crude price as well as Brent, North Sea Brent crude price, in a ratio of 65.2 to 34.8%. The logic of this ratio is India imports majority of crude oil from Gulf countries, Gulf and Mediterranean countries, West Africa. So sour crude oil is primarily imported from Gulf countries, and sweet crude oil is imported from Africa, and all sweet crude oil from Africa is pegged to the North Sea Brent crude oil price. So India, Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas of India uses the ratio of sour and sweet crude prices, that is UAE Dubai crude price and Brent prices, in the ratio of 65.2 to 34.8, to arrive at the international crude oil price for Indian basket. So I'll just take you through. This is how this is the website of this is a website of Ministry of Petroleum and yes, I hope you are able to see this particular detail. So you have on a daily basis, Press Information Bureau releases the crude oil price for the Indian basket. So this is the detail which is available from on 22nd June 2016. So what is the crude oil price? It has taken 47.02. This is the price prevailing on June 21st, 2016. And multiplied by the exchange rate prevailing on that day, RBI reference rate prevailing on that day, so 67.48 rupees per US dollar. So this two multiplied by 47.02 multiplied by 67.48 gives the INR price, rupee price of barrel of crude oil. So with this, I would like to summarize this session on crude oil. So we started discussing the importance of crude oil. We also briefly discussed how crude oil is refined to arrive different kind of refined products. And a 1 barrel of crude oil, which is equivalent to 42 gallons, can be refined to generate 45 gallons of different refined products. We also started discussing how the spot price is arrived, or how do we get to know what is the spot price, how the spot prices gets arrived, and how the spot prices are reported for 4 global important crude oil. And these 4 important crude oil is your USA WTI crude oil, North Sea Brent crude oil, OPEC reference basket, and also United Arab Emirates Dubai Light. Besides these 4 important crude oil, also other industry bodies report different indices. So some of the important indices is the Argus Sour Crude Index and Japan Crude Cocktail Index and India's reference basket for India's reference basket for crude oil. So I would like to end up the session here today, and looking forward to meeting you all in the next session. Thank you, all of you.